honestly don't even understand how I accepted collaborating in this case. I shouldn't have listened to my wife. I know she thinks I'm capable, but I'm just not ready. These pills they prescribed me make me feel weak. And I don't know if I'll be of much help.
Thank you.
1947. Four students gone missing in a university as prestigious as this one, and Director Holtwick gives me a week to help him sort this out. I don't even know where to start. And why only 7 days? Thankfully, the police force will do anything necessary to solve the case. My hands, however, are tied. Why contract a private detective for such a few days? I don't understand. But if it hadn't been for that, I wouldn't have accepted the job.
Post-traumatic stress. Really? Some people make up a load of bullshit to stop working. Seriously, why am I always the one to deal with loonies? A mentally disturbed guy who becomes a private detective and who doesn't like his job. That's all I need. I'm running out of patience, and this has just begun.
March 30th, 1947. Today I went to interrogate Rector Holtwick. A curious subject as there ever was. He seems to be a smart and cult man. He defends his ideals regarding the advance in all fields of medicine, be it physical or mental. And what strikes me the most is that he has no qualms in flattering other scientists whose methods aren't the least orthodox.
New wrinkle! The key you just obtained opens the door at the floor below! Go there. We're going to add some difficulty. I hope you don't mind. I'm warning you. I'm not going to intervene during the level. I trust you're not going to chicken out now.
Teaching classes isn't my thing. I don't know how long I'll be able to bear with this cover. While I'm teaching, my head spins unceasingly to find the solution to the compatibility problem between donor and receiver. It's difficult enough finding an Imperial Eagle to jeopardize one of its extremities again. I only want my working hours to end to continue my investigation in the hole. feel a little guilty. If these agents are poking about so enthusiastically, it must be because I've done something wrong. It would be a pity that all of our hard work went to waste because of me. If I didn't tell Dr. Holtwick, it would be as if I was lying to him. I should warn him and assume the consequences.
I spent several hours looking for Professor Evelyn O'Donnell. I've had her practically glued to me as I worked, and now that I want to speak with her, she has disappeared from the face of the earth. Seeing such a peculiar professorate, I wonder how the students from this place must be. I imagine that having to lacerate bodies and observe entrails every day ends up disturbing you. Even if it's only a little... I'd better warn the police force to have an eye on Evelyn before I withdraw from the case.
And on top of all, I have to put up with that bat. He thinks that for having been here for longer than I, he can give me orders. He and his theories on conspiracy can all go to hell. In get wasted.
smile the other day as I carried out the protocols and asked, scared, if I enjoyed what I did. Truth is, he made me think about the situation. Do I enjoy it? It's true that human traits cannot be attributed to an animal. But would it be fair to consider the lion as sadistic because she has to kill the gazelle to feed her cubs? It isn't the process that is enjoyed, but the result. I imagine that the lioness will enjoy having some peace of mind, knowing that her cubs can be properly fed. When it comes to survival, you don't just beat around the bush. And sometimes I think that we are hypersensitive.
I don't know where my companions are. I've locked myself in a room, and I'm hoping somebody will find me. I feel worse every minute, and I can't find my pills. I'm getting paranoid. I think I've already lost any contact with reality. I don't know what to do. I'm really, really frightened. April 2nd, 1947. I had never seen anything like this. Nothing good could come out of this place. It's been a couple of days in which I've been sleep deprived. The anxiety is such that I barely stop shivering. My retinas are dehydrated. I'm unable to concentrate. I feel I'm becoming paranoid. Thank you. over again. This has been happening to me ever since I got out of that damn ship. From that time, I can only remember seeing my companions completely overwhelmed by the situation, surrounded by thick green mist. I remember closing my eyes, unable to stop hearing screams, gasps, lamentations. I feel really dizzy, and I don't even know where these ducks take to. I can't stop thinking about my wife and son. They are the reason I can still go on. April 2nd, 1947. Benjamin Bennett.
I'm sick of this place. We're gathering possible evidence in the area related to those who've gone missing, but this is not my kind of job. If there are no people whom we can get information from, I'm not going to waste my time searching and reading documents. That's what the freshmen from the station are for. These kids who believe in values such as law and order, who think that doing what is legitimately correct is the only...
You certainly managed to pull through all the time. Who'd imagine it's the first time you do it? Let us make a deal. Run, right away, and we'll forget everything that happened. Well, kid, whatever you want to get out of here, just tell me, and we'll negotiate. What do you think? You must think something.
Thank you. should have seen yourself some minutes ago. Oh, you look disturbed, and you were delirious. But some minutes after, wham! You've arrived up here on your own and...
Good! There are some boxes in the backyard. You can play with them by using the electromagnet. I've marked where you have to go on the map so that you don't get lost. Once you find them, aim at them with the electromagnet and use it. Remember to activate it. like a superhero with the gadget you got in your hands. I wouldn't add anything else. No, no, it could explode any time. A little more. You're almost out of here.
Thank you.
come and get you? Can't you see he wants to become emancipated? You should let the little one fly! Oh, how touching! He is very excited! If you say so. I'm going to help you a little, but I need you to do something first. A week ago, things got a little nasty, and I had some trouble with some guy. He hit some stone tablets outside the university, all over the unnecessary for the correct functioning of many of my devices. I need to find them. I'm aware that this may look like a game to you, but I promise you it's not. Once you place all the tablets in their corresponding slots, I'll offer you my invaluable help.
Thank you.
woods. Well, I just made that up. But hurry up, or you'll hop the twig.
Thank you. Thank you.
unexpected happened. Nothing serious. I have to write a report on behavioral conditioning and I have to finish a couple of prototypes now that you've activated the monoliths. But I promise I'll be guiding you. I give you my Boy Scout word. By the way, I was thinking, I want to tell you a secret, and I don't know how to do it. Truth is, from the very
says. He'll manipulate you and do whatever he pleases with you. Trust me, I'm going to guide you to the exit. I know these old sewers by heart. By the way, I'm Robert Kansas. I worked with your father in his last case in this university. He is a great guy. When we were investigating the case, he talked about your mother and you a lot. This was a long time ago. Is filtered. It looks like the mechanism can be used. So, to get out of here, the first thing you have to do is to go to the pressure control room to lower the water level. Careful with this water. All residual water from those damn machines gets through here. The other side by using these platforms, but try not to fall. Thank you.
7, 3, 1, 5.
Situation before. I trust you'll be able to solve it without my help. Honestly, I'm not very good at these things.
Thank you.
and out of hell. Once you've escaped, my advice is that you don't even try to get back to save your father. Sorry, I didn't tell you. Forget about finding your father. I'm getting you to the exit, and I'm sure your father would want the same. Helping your father's not worth it. He's not the same as he was before. The best you can do is to get back home. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for being harsh, but you've already lived a long time without him. And if you try to rescue him, I don't think you'll like what you'll find. is shattered. All you've done becomes meaningless. Not knowing what to think or what to believe in. I've been working for Holtwick for almost 20 years. And you might not believe this, but I was a police officer before. Working here was something sudden, and I didn't have time to assimilate it. I never imagined myself working in a business. And I've seen a lot of things here. And not to see many others. And seeing you here, I realized the mistake I've made. Okay, your freedom's right behind that door. Run away and forget all of this. Your nightmare will end here. My work here is done. At least I can do something right.
your father. I don't. We've been very fortunate to find one another. Your father told me he wants to retire. He doesn't look as eager as the first time. The life in his eyes is practically gone. Call me that if you like. When I speak with him, it's as if I was talking to the dead.
Thank you.
Dad. I miss you so much. Do you remember all we learned together? Ever since you gave me the key to your lab as a present for my 15th birthday, science has been my passion. And I owe this to you. Thanks to that, now I'm working next to one of the most reputed doctors in medicine in all of history, and friend of yours. Dr. William Hultwick. Now he's like my father. He takes care of me, he teaches me, and he gives me reason to keep going. I miss you so much, Dad. I know you couldn't get over Mom abandoning you. And I know what finished you off was that damned letter she sent you some years after. What would have happened if Mom hadn't abandoned us? Maybe the three of us would still be together now, as a family. to show how strong I am. I won't collapse. I promise. After your confession, I feel I've overcome what happened to my parents, and I feel closer to you. There are no doubts or laments left. I must only worry about science. I know you trust me, and I'll show you I'm completely committed to your work.
Thank you.
series of underground tunnels which connects several areas. It's a good way to investigate without being seen. These tunnels are old, but they seem to be used frequently. This is making me uneasy.
To the University of Medicine and Applied Sciences of Crowswood. Each and every one of you have been chosen for your aptitudes, intelligence, and excellence. Despite your qualities, don't you even dare to think this will be a piece of cake. No. You'll learn how to create your own formulas. You'll have access to the most advanced technology. And you'll learn that morals are no more than another burden imposed by society to impede us to advance. In this university, neither I nor any of the professors will limit you in the intellectual field. Discipline, however, is essential. Any lack of discipline will be sanctioned and might lead to expulsion from this university. Having stated that, you can go to the corresponding classrooms and the professors will tell you all you need to know. Good luck. You'll need it.
left to say.
Thank you.
understand it. It's all written, and nothing can be done to change it. Having hope might prolong agony to make the ending more complex than it is, but it's not worth a try.
Thank you.
Dr. William Holtwick has asked me to take his place for a while. I think it's important that I duly introduce myself. My name is Evelyn O'Donnell. What's your name? Not answering is also an option. But I'd rather you did answer. This attitude will get you nowhere. William is a genius. He's the mastermind of all of this. He's the brain. The brain keeps the structure together. Without the brain, everything's out of control. People like him have made a difference in history. And in many occasions, they haven't even received the acknowledgement that they deserve. A good way to acknowledge what he's done could be collaborating.
Thank you. and the organization hadn't seen you in the hole before. My name is Hans Delacroix. What? You don't belong here? And what are you doing?
How did you get in here?
It's been 20 years since I last saw a new face or had a conversation. Has anything changed outside? Look, I don't think you should be in here with me. I don't want you to get in trouble because of me,
buddy.
During the last 30 years, I've been working under Dr. William Holtwick's orders. What did you say? There's nobody outside. So who's been bringing me food all this time? All right. If you get me out of here, I'll give you one of the batteries you need to use the elevator and get out of here.
Thank you.
won't. Be very careful. When I said I'd make sure you wouldn't get out of here, I didn't mean that you'd continue with what you were doing up to now. Repeating the same process over and over and over again. Your life is weak. It's hanging by a thread. I can finish it off whenever I please. Perhaps I'd even be doing you a favor.
Sense anymore. This is the last one I'll make. sorry, Benjamin. When the bosses closed the case and everything happened, somehow I knew you'd come off badly. Back then, I didn't just stand there. I asked Holtwick for an explanation. I knew he had orchestrated all disappearances. Even he admitted it. It was very easy. He only had to obtain an order and William Holtwick would go down in history. But by the time we finished talking, I didn't want to do it. He showed me around the place. He showed me his inventions, successful experiments, even unsuccessful ones. And as he finished showing me everything and giving me an explanation, I lost interest in locking him up. I saw the progress, the development. I don't know how he did it, but the disturbed way in which he saw the world was contagious, and finishing what I started didn't make any sense anymore. He suggested me to join him, and I simply accepted. He got me to lend my body to help him. I feel like a fool talking to nobody. This recording will never get to you, but I need to redeem myself, and I don't know how to do it.
All of these abominations were once people who served as test subjects. I've lost count of the time they've been there, or how many there are. They've outstandingly served their purpose, and I've given them the opportunity to live longer lives. But some of them are the bad memory of failed experiments.
You can't blame me for having done what you expected me to do. William!
I hope you'd be beyond this! You've deceived me. Your impulsions towards the boy almost spoil everything.
You knew it would end like this, didn't you?
Goodbye, Evelyn.
Of my mental faculties, freely and after long deliberation, I state that William Holdwick has full capacity to decide on both my health and my life indefinitely, as he did with my parents. I consider he is the only one in the world able to put science before his own life. And my wish is that somebody with this gift can decide on my life as long as the objective is knowledge and the progress of mankind. I hereby sign this statement after thorough consideration, and I ask that my will is respected.
Shameful! I wasn't expecting this!
What a disappointment!
I'm sorry you witnessed such a deplorable scene, but you heard it! She was willing to do anything for the progress of science! Ah, it angers me that she believes she was able to make her own decisions. I'm sure you're different. Ooh, yes, I'm sure. We'll do great things together.
Destiny. Believe me, when I say I tried my best, but no matter how many trials I overcame, no matter how much I investigated, I wasn't able to accomplish anything. I don't even know how long I've been here. Although without hope, I trust that you will find the way. I love you.
the answers you could possibly need.
As a token for having arrived so far, I'm going to give you a small gift. Your father is here with me. Greet your son, Mr. Bennett. Point. I'll give you all the time you need to get through that door, helping you to satisfy your curiosity for what has happened and meet your father again.
To arrive someday. 288 attempts endorse your perseverance. As I told you before, I know you have many questions, and I'm going to grant you the pleasure of knowing the answers. In the first place, allow me to introduce you to your father. 20 years have passed since you last saw him. Well then, the first answer I suppose you want to hear is, why you're here? You see, truth is, the only one to blame for you being here is your own father. I guess that during your walk through the university, you have heard about something called the Philadelphia Experiment. In 1943, the U.S. Army came asking me for help. They told me they needed to find a way to make their ships undetectable, dodging the enemy radars. They offered me a great deal of money and, for the good of science, I accepted. I was in charge of a group belonging to the scientific elite of the time, and we developed a system based on electromagnetic waves to create a field that surrounds the ship so the sound waves coming from enemy radars would get through it. Something went wrong. I don't know whether it was due to some miscalculations or the executors manipulating everything wrongly. But what at first was meant to be an inoffensive experiment ended with the lives of ten submarines and a one-way ticket to the madhouse for others. The only person who got out of there unharmed was your father. Once the experiment finished, the survivors were transferred and examined. I had to carry out some tests on Benjamin. I discovered his brain activity surpassed the usual limits, so I decided to investigate further. Years later, I called him to come to this university to investigate several disappearances, of which I myself was guilty for, and to carry out as many tests as I willed without having to give bureaucratic explanations. That was when I discovered the cause of his high brain activity. A part of his brain had awakened, which responded to dangerous stimuli, recreating a possible future according to the president. That's to say, he was able to have premonitions whenever he or a loved one was in danger. As you've observed, the university is full of cameras, and all of these monitors reflect what's been going on all this time. I forced your father to watch you in the few dangerous situations you've encountered, and I've monitored his response to said stimuli. I wanted to use those studies to play God, but during these 20 years, I haven't found a way to profit from such power. My last hope was bringing his stimulus to the limit with you. Has also failed. Another thing I suppose you'll be asking yourself is, what is this place? As you may have already figured, it's not any ordinary university. Some years ago, nobody wanted me to become part of their projects, given the fact that I'm well known for my lack of morality. I decided that my knowledge had to be shared with promising young prodigies on the fields of science and medicine, who would have no qualms about doing what others would categorize as atrocities. They are necessary sacrifices. What would become a medicine if atrocities and perfidious features of which humanity repents from had taken place? The end justifies all means. That's why I created this institution, a place where only the most bright and decided people would be chosen by me to work under my orders. As experiments advanced, it wasn't enough to have one or two laboratories locked with a simple key at the university. I needed a place where nobody could snoop around. And what better place could there be than right beneath it? Once to this point, and having satisfied your curiosity, I am pleased to inform you that you'll be an excellent test subject. This is only the beginning!